and they were both very happy. Soon the time came for Niamh to return to Tir na n'Og. She begged Oisin to go with her to Tir na n'Og. She told him he would never grow old and that he would be happy forever. Because he loved Niamh so dearly, Oisin agreed to go with her to Tir na n'Og. There was much sadness when the people of Ireland waved goodbye to Oisin and Niamh. Before long, the great white horse was carrying them off to the west. With just a few galloping strides, they reached the coast at Connemara. Then the horse galloped over the tops of the waves and off out to sea. When Oisin looked back, Ireland had disappeared below the horizon. In no time at all, they reached the magical land of Tir na n'Og. The king and queen of Tir na n'Og welcomed Oisin to his new home. They had heard much about Oisin and his poetry. They were happy to have him as their son-in-law. The next day, Niamh and Oisin were married. The wedding feast was the finest ever seen. Everyone in Tir na n'Og was invited.